यो चाहिँ मणिपाल कलेजको फेक एडमिसन केसको 2015 चल्दै आएको सो सिक्किममा हाम्रो सदर थानामा 3 केस छ अन्तखेरि 2019 लास्ट इयर चाहिँ केस नम्बर 4 मणिपालमा त्यही फेक एडमिसनको चाहिँ हाम्रो सिआइडीमा रेजिस्टर भएको थियो त्यसमा चाहिँ दि आयो अफ द केस वाज एएसपी रेन्जिङ छोपेल राई एन्ड देन टिल नाउ प्रिभियस 3 केसेसमा Despite the efforts of the investigating officer of the previous cases, we could not arrest the kingpin who was responsible for this particular racket. So finally, our team led by ASP Ranjan Chopel along with PI Abhishek Dahal and two more of the team members, we are here Friday, location of them confirmed by Sagaracha. Saturday they left from Gangtok to Siliguri. स्याटरडे यिनीहरू पुगेर दिनभरि बेलुकासम्म चाहिँ सर्भेलेन्स गरेर विथ द हेल्प अफ सिलिगुडी पुलिस एज वेल एज एसपिएसटिएफ नर्थ बेङ्गल वी वर एबल टु अरेस्ट एफेक्ट अरेस्ट अफ दि अक्युज अन सन्डे आफ्टरनुन सो सन्डे आफ्टरनुन अरेस्ट गर्ने बित्तिकै वी वर एबल टु सिज 3 मोबाइल फोन्स एन्ड एप्पल म्याकबुक प्रो अ ब्रान्ड न्यू वेहिकल अलोङ विथ 31+ SIM cards of various service providers and a lot of dongles, internet dongles, you know. So this is the brief of the whole operation that was conducted. Now we have to be very, very careful because your manche is very well connected, sir. So every time any of the team from Sikkim police used to go to Siliguri, somehow ule thapai altyo. So this time it was very, very, it was a very secretive kind of move that we made. We did not tell anyone. And immediately a small team was dispatched from here and then the team was very, very, you know, effectively, the team very effectively could effect arrest of this particular accused. The accused ko naam se ho Sumantra Gupta, son of Saibal Gupta and resident of Mal Bazar. And right now it's just been about, 24 hours since we have effected arrest and we have got police custody for the next 5 days. And now the next 5 days would be very, very essential for us to understand what exactly he did, how we operated. As far as the interrogation we can find more than 40 victims. And you know, the amount of money that he has fleeced from these 40 victims could be in the tune of 3+ crore rupees. Okay? And presently when we apprehended him also, he was still operating, not for Manipal, but for some other college. The details of those things, eye of the case, Amro Rendin Chopel Rai, he would be providing. Amro Sanga table ma, Amro Police Department ko PRO Madam Pani Ununsa, Heshe Madam, she is the Public Relations Officer of Sikkim Police and she also is in this press conference, you know, as a part of the Sikkim Police team. So now if you have any questions, I would, you know, request you to question it and the eye of the case, Mr. Rendin Chopel, will answer all your queries.
Well, what are the sections, under which section he has been booked?
419, 420, 468, 471, and 66(c) and (d) of IT Act 2000.
So in plain words it is cheating, impersonation, forgery as well as criminal conspiracy 120B pani sao, plus IT Act ma 66(c) and (d) using you know IT mechanisms to dupe people off the money. So that's
So, he's alone or what group
police, sir? Actually, modus operandi, case, usually, usko associates on roncha. Junjeje amile mancha, we call them technically money mules uncha. So, unago different accounts uncha, bank accounts or unago namma kolleg uncha, orugo namma kolleg. They already have a setup wherein they say that I'm transferring this amount of money. So this percentage will go as a commission to you. Mm-hmm. So two para chha unale operate garcha in a coordinated way. So yes, ma jiki problem huncha na hamilai tyo paisa jasto moment huncha. That is another part of investigation, but primarily identification of the accused and his accomplices. So there are a lot of people who are connected with the crime. That is the reason initially when we have this kind of crime, hamile 120B mini law huncha, that is criminal conspiracy because we believe and there are a lot of other people also involved together.
So basically he was like, you know, doing this for the seats of Manipal, right? So मणिपालको केसमा मात्रै चाहिँ कतिजना भिक्टिम छ एन्ड हाउ मेनी अफ देम हैव लस्ट अफिसियली कम्प्लेन विथ द सिक्किम पुलिस.
So that's what अघि भनेको जस्तै अक्रस थ्री or फोर केसेस वी हेभ 40 प्लस विक्टिम्स नेम्ड विक्टिम्स इन दोज. यस यस ओन्ली विथ मणिपाल. इन सिक्किम द ओन्ली कॉलेज ही हेज डेल्ट विथ इज मणिपाल एन्ड कोइन्सिडेन्टली ही ऑल्सो हेपन्स टू बी अ स्टुडेन्ट अफ मणिपाल हु स्टडिड इन सिक्किम मणिपाल इन्स्टिट्युट अफ मेडिकल साइन्सेस. 2001 उहाँले एडमिसन यहाँ लिएको थियो. 2001 5 he was here. लास्ट सेमेस्टर एक्जाम चाहिँ दे नदिकन गएको यहाँबाट. सो ही वाज अ स्टुडेन्ट अफ मणिपाल. हि न्यू द सिस्टम्स इन मणिपाल. हि न्यू द पिपल इनसाइड मणिपाल. 2005 वेन ही लेफ्ट सिक्किम वेन ही कुड नट कम्प्लिट हिज ग्रेजुएसन बिपिटी गर्दै थियो. सो ही लेफ्ट फ्रम हियर एन्ड देन 2008-09 चाहिँ ही स्टार्टेड फिडलिङ इन टु दिस एरिया अफ यु नो क्राइम. सो द्याट्स हाउ हिज प्रोग्रेस हेज बिन. And before you ask specific questions, modus operandi che esma impersonation. Why? Because he was impersonating himself as the dean of Sikkim Manipal Institute of Medical Sciences. Previously, afula dean Juneja bhanera, he used to contact other senior doctors and then offer them jobs. At the same time, he would also want to, you know, inform them that due to a seat being lying vacant, hamro ma chai euta seat cha. यो चाहिँ हामीहरूले एडमिसनमा चाहिँ त्यो मान्छेले सिट पाएको थियो उसले चाहिँ नलिने भयो. सो वान सिट इज एम्टी. फर द्याट सिट वी हेभ गट दि अप्रुभल फ्रम द मिनिस्ट्री अफ हेल्थ एन्ड सोसियल वेलफेयर गभर्मेन्ट अफ इन्डिया भनेर सर्टिफिकेट पनि बनाएर एन्ड देन द्याट इज हाउ युज टु ड्युप मनी फ्रम यु नो प्रोस्पेक्टिभ क्लाइन्ट्स. सो द्याट इज हाउ. बट द इस्यु इज इन अल अफ दिस 40 केसेस the money was always deposited through an online transaction. It was hardly, you know, any time cash was exchanged. So despite lot of awareness programs by Manipal themselves, when they clearly say that we do not have any middlemen handling our admission process, still people used to believe him because he impersonated himself as Dr. Juneja and subsequently Dr. Mehta. So he was able to do this for so long because the amount of money involved was huge, and yes, I am sure he has paid a lot of people to ensure his safety.
If specific, yeah. High amount labor, low amount, what is just the difference?
Why is it difficult? As far as I know, your case mein kya baat hai? Mani, yeah, hamile apne investigation ko dooran chahi. Once the case was registered, हाम्रो आफ्नो इन्टेलिजेन्स इन्पुट सोर्सेसहरूबाट चाहिँ वी फाउन्ड आउट द्याट वान पर्सन वाज देयर इन होटेल समवेयर इन तादोङ. त्यहाँ उसको फ्यामिलीसँग जाँदाखेरि हामी त्यहाँ गएर चाहिँ इन्टरसेप्ट गर्दाखेरि ऊ आएको छैन, बट दे वर इन द प्रोसेस अफ गेटिङ ड्युप. सो रफली अराउन्ड म्याक्सिमम अमाउन्ट हियर ड्युप इज अराउन्ड 19 लाख्स एन्ड द मिनिमम इज अराउन्ड 4 लाख्स टु 5 लाख्स.
इज दिस मेडिकल नॉट फॉर द इंजीनियरिंग
सेक्टर? इट्स ओन्ली फॉर मेडिकल.
ओन्ली फॉर मेडिकल.
ही हिमसेल्फ, या ही हिमसेल्फ वाज अ स्टूडेंट ऑफ SMIMS. 2001 में एडमिशन लिएको थियो
उले. जति पनि भिक्टिमहरु छ प्राय जसो कुन क्षेत्रबाट छ? सिक्किमको केही सिक्किमको बाहिरबाट
छ. दिस इज एक्चुअली प्यान इन्डिया. तपाईँको हेर्नु भएन, हामीले इन्भेस्टिगेसन गर्दा हरियाणाको छ, महाराष्ट्रको छ, ओडिसाको छ, तपाईँको आसामको छ, युपीको छ, बिहारको छ. अलमोस्ट अल द प्लेसेस अल ओभर इन्डिया.
सो यु युज टु आस्क मनी टु ट्रान्सफर अनलाइन. So
once all the money is like transferred, then what was his next move? I mean, then obviously there is a process. What happens is once the entire amount is transferred and he knows that the other person now he is in the process of returning the money back. He will tell the person that I'll return your money back. So in that process, then he gradually goes undercover. He flees or he goes undercover. Then subsequently the FIR is lodged and police comes into so, action.
Apart from that, junse hamile hijo seize gareko cha, we have seized over 31 SIM cards. So if one were to think logically, and eventually we will, we have spoken with him also, the modus operandi is obviously when the money is transferred, for him the crime has been committed. For him, the benefit has been already made, right? Subsequently, he would ask them to deposit further money as tapaiko, let's say, February 2 tarikh chai hostel ko pani allotment hundaisa bhanera. Allotment charges are 15,000 rupees, vagera bhanera, right? So people eventually they would land up in Sikkim, believing that they have a genuine, you know, admission into SMIMS along with the documents that he has communicated to them. So when they land over here, subsequently they get to know that they have been duped. That is how, you know, in an admission season, say, complaint hamroma hundakheri. Yoda complaint, there are 10 complainants, the second one is 14, the third one is again 10 complainants. So it's admission season mane huncha. So when people land up over here, let's say if there are 14 of them who landed over there who have been duped, they go to college and then subsequently they realize that they have been duped. Now they have not met the person, they have only communicated to a person who impersonated himself as Dr. Juneja, the Dean of SMIMS, or Dr. Mehta, the Dean of SMIMS. So yes, the whole process of transaction of money happened through RTGS or through, you know, Paytm or through some kind of online banking mechanism. So once the money is with him and the people who have been duped are in Sikkim, then obviously he would change all his contacts.
Right.
Or if someone, you know, who is able to find his contacts, he would try to ensure that he tries to, you know, make an agreement with him, is bar admission nahi hua, we'll try to return your money. That is only a small percentage of, you know, if the person who took admission and then got his contact details. So he is a very, very well crafted con man, okay. So to speak.
Sorry, jun chai bhanu hundai cha, usko chai sequence he has already prepared from the first start of the con ko process start garnu, then how will, and he has already prepared each of the sequences.
And apart from Sikkim ma matra chatta case bhayo na, across India, if not less than 10 cases would be against him, because the victims are in every corner of this country, right? So for instance, if someone would come over here, they did not personally come to complain to the police over here. Why? Because they came over here, they realized they've been duped and they went back to their own states. Afno state ma gaera unharle complaint dieko cha. Yahanira cha hamro complaints, it came in a consolidated form, wherein let's say the dean of SMIMS at that point of time, Dr. Mehta or Dr. Juneja, they themselves came to the police station, to police headquarters, to submit a complaint which consists of all these people who have been duped by this particular person. Yes, absolutely correct. Whenever there's a crime which happens, especially with regard to cyber crime, there's always this tendency of the people who are victims to do things because either they are, you know, it's greed or benefit. Now, greed in business sense, because they'll earn more money. In this particular case, it is benefit. They're saying that despite not being able to get admission into certain kind of colleges, Manipal Sikkim Manipal, which is highly ranked amongst NEET candidates, if you are paying 20 lakhs, 25 lakhs as capitation fee or management fee, then you will be getting this particular seat. But obviously, they're taking it. So yes, there is to some extent, I won't call it, you know, simplicity, but yes, the people, the victims in this case is also, you know, deposited money, gave money to gain out of a process which is not completely legal. Because we all know that the admission process is very, very stringent. NEET karnu padcha, counseling huncha, depending upon your rank, you get those colleges. Whereas if you are not able to make into the merit, so obviously the victims also get to benefit, and agar family ma doctor sa, in most of the cases, the contact person would be your doctor. Because Sumantra Gupta would impersonate himself as the dean of this college. So the person on the other side is also a doctor, and he would ask references and he would know, okay, Dr. Juneja, I know him. So through that process, again, when you produce a document which says that, okay, one seat is lying vacant and we have been given permission by the Ministry of Home and Health and Social Welfare. And for this, Hamra Ayole, from the beginning itself, we had been communicating to all of them. Registered email ID, Junsai Sir, Sumantra Gupta ka naam ma cha, Junsai document, Health and Social Welfare bara bhaneko thyo, Government of India la hamle pathako thyo. Government of India also returned back to us MHA saying ki we do not issue such kind of, you know, documents, and they have also given direction to Commissioner of Police Delhi to conduct inquiry on that, and they also have told us ki tapaiharuko jati investigation ma je je tapaile thaha pauncha kindly intimate us whatever is happening bhanera.
Mm-hmm.
त्यो तपाईँको इन्भेस्टिगेसन त अब इन्टरोगेसन आजदेखि स्टार्ट हुँदैछ. सो फर द्याट आई थिङ्क वी क्यान कम अप विथ मोर कन्क्रिट रिजल्ट्स इन द फ्युचर है तपाईँलाई आन्सर. अन द अदर एन्ड भने जुन चाहिँ रिटर्नको बादमा चाहिँ त्यही भनेको उसको मोडल्स अफ प्रान्डी चाहिँ एउटा मान्छेलाई जब वेन यु हेभ गिभन सम अमाउन्ट टु सम वान यु एन्ड सम वान इज गिभिङ यु ओके 50,000 ब्याक देन देयर इज अ होप द्याट हि मे गिभ यु ब्याक भनेर अगेन. सो त्यो भएर चाहिँ उसले ह्याङ गरिराखिदिन्छ क्या तपाईँलाई.
To your question, I think, so in this investigation, there are lots and lots of bank now account numbers which have been used. And IO is already in the process of sending, letters to all these banks to freeze the amount. Some of them have already freeze the amount, right? So let's say if there are 10 bank accounts, from each bank account also we are able to freeze 5 lakh, 6 lakh, 10 lakh rupees. So maybe we might be able to freeze 60, 70, 80 lakhs. So let's say at the end of it, after the case, how exactly to dispose of that particular procedure of the crime towards victim compensation, that is more to do with the court. Courtly, I'm like, kosta pali order dincha, tei huncha. Because
age
41.
Yeah. Sumantra Gupta. Yeah, so there are different kind of cases. Siliguri ma wildlife smuggling ko pani case,
Same person.
Yes, Karshong ma I believe there is a case of ke bancha child trafficking case sa bande sa. So he seems to be someone, obviously when we speak with him, he claims to be the victim, but we all know all con men are like that.